Now let's meet our third team of challengers. What is your name, please?
My name is Luke Halpin.
My name is Luke Halpin.
My name is Luke Halpin.
Follow along once again, if you will, panel, while I read you this story. I, Luke Halpin, played in my first movie about 2 years ago. In the movie, I played the part of a boy who becomes great pals with an unusual character named Flipper. The part of Flipper was played by a female porpoise named Mitzi. Since porpoises will respond better to people who have helped train them, I had to learn porpoise training. The training sessions went on for about 2 months. Mitzi learned to come when I called, fetch objects for me, and tow me around on her back. The movie Flipper was so successful that we made another called Flipper's New Adventures. In this sequel, my co-star is another female porpoise named Susie. Signed, Luke Halpin. Panel, these three young men all claim to be Luke Halpin, Flipper's co-star in the movie by the same name. Let's start this round with Flipper Bean, Orson Bean.
Thank you, buddy, old buddy, but I must disqualify myself because I know one of these three young gentlemen. We were on an exhibition to the highest Himalayas. I don't want to go into the details.
I thought you were going to say you knew Flipper.
No,
Okay, that will go as an incorrect vote. Kitty, suppose we start with you in that case.
Number one, how old were you supposed to be in the first Flipper series about 2 years ago? There's a breeze over here.
13.
You were supposed to be 13. Number two, which Flipper did you like best, Susie or the first one?
There was only one.
I thought in the first film there was another Flipper, porpoise.
Huh? The movie you're talking about that he made with him was the one. There was only one in that one.
But you made two pictures.
Yes, I did.
And there was only one porpoise.
There were two porpoises. One porpoise for one picture, one porpoise
for
another picture.
Well, that's what I said. Which one did you like best?
Oh, which one did I like best?
Yeah.
I like Mitzi better.
You like Mitzi better. Number three, do you like Mitzi better?
Yes, she was.
Why is she more affectionate?
She was easier to handle.
Number one, did you have to get in the tank with Flipper?
Yes.
What did you wear? Well, you could have worn a tank suit or something, I don't know, or grease all over you to keep warm.
Cut down blue jeans.
Cut down blue jeans, you see. It wasn't just a bathing suit.
I'm posting.
Yeah, it wasn't just a bathing suit. Which one did you like the best, number one?
Mitzi.
That's the first one?
Yes.
Why did you prefer Mitzi to Susie? I hope you're not listening, Susie. We're just kidding around here. I mean,
more affectionate.
Is that so? Number two, do you swim well?
Pretty well, yes, sir.
Do you know what the difference between an overhand stroke and an Australian crawl is?
Yes, I do.
Oh, good. Number three?
You didn't ask him what it was.
You're right. Number three, what's the difference between those two strokes and the freestyle?
I don't know, sir.
I guess I should have asked you if you swam. I didn't do
it. Peggy Katz.
Number two, who produced Flipper?
Iron Tours.
Number three, was Flipper in color?
Yes, it was.
Number one, did you work in the ocean, in the outside ocean, or just in tanks?
We worked in a pen.
In a pen? Oh, number two, where was your girlfriend Mitzi from?
She's from California.
Number three, was it shot like out of marine land out there?
No, it wasn't.
Oh, number one, what color was Flipper?
Gray.
Number three, there's a new movie about a porpoise. Do you know the name of the new movie about a porpoise?
It's the one that I did.
Well, I meant another one in
That's a fish.
Oh,
that's all we have.
A fish is not a porpoise.
Time for
uh-huh.
Oh, with your
well, you can bicker about this one later because I want you to mark your ballots now, if you will, please. That's all the time we have, and I don't want you consulting while you're marking. Simply mark it once without change and vote for number one, number two, our number three. All balloting completed. All right, Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number one. I saw pictures of the movie. I didn't see the movie, but I saw pictures of it. And I must admit that he had a face mask over, so I couldn't tell anything about him, except he had a cute turned-up nose. The number one has a turned-up nose, so I think it's a peak.
Peggy.
I voted for number two. because I thought if he was he was the right size to have made that picture 2 years ago, and also he was kind of like talking very as though it'd catch on. I don't know, but I think it's true.
Orson, you disqualified yourself, so your vote is... You're quite right. And Kitty, what is your choice?
I voted for number one for the same reason that Peggy voted for number two. I thought that if he was supposed to be 13 2 years ago, he would have looked 13. It's quite true I very often vote for the right one for the wrong reason. Number two might have supposed to have been 15, and he might have looked 15 2 years ago. But that's why I voted for number one.
Do you ever wear a feather boa? Just for Orson. Well, the votes are all in. Let's go for the truth now, shall we? And learn quickly, before the suspense abates, just which one of these three young men actually did co-star, as you can say, with Flipper. Will the real Luke Halpin please stand up?
It is. Ah!
Thank you very much, Luke.
Which one did you know?
And continued success to you, young man. I hope you make a big career out of it.
Thank you.
Now let's check your two friends here. Number two, what is your real name and what do you really do?
Well, my name is Mark Diamond, and I'm a sophomore at collegiate school here in the city.
And number three, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Bill Sear, and I'm a part-time design engineer for Sonatone Corporation.
Well, gentlemen, I'm sure you probably added up and spent the money already because there was one incorrect vote that was disqualified by Orson. That put money in the bank for you right away. And then one other incorrect one, a total of twice $250 is $500 coming your way from Dristan, as well as, of course, on your way out a gift package of all the fine products that make us a Dristan. Our thanks to you and hope you had fun with it. We did. Goodbye. And God bless you. Oh, yes. Hold everything. I want to find out how and which one you know.
I know the real Luke Halpin because he's a splendid actor and he played my kid in a TV show.
Ah, that's the reason you know.
He was a lot smaller.
I almost forgot to clear that up. Thank you very much, Orson. Good night again to you, gentlemen. Oh, my.
Oh, my, really.
Stay tuned. There's more Black and White Overnight coming right up.
That's all we have time for tonight, but think what you learned.
I'm not going home. I'm just going to sit here and think about it.
Thank you for being your bright, wonderful selves. I'm always grateful for that. Good night to you. Good night to all of you, and don't forget to join us at the same time next week. And, of course, I'll see you tomorrow afternoon on the daytime show. In the meantime, good night to you from Tristan, and may I remind you once again to tell the truth. Bye.
To Tell the Truth is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. The Truth has been brought to you by Anacin, the headache tablet to relieve headache pain, to relax tension, calm nerves. Anacin. This is Johnny Olson speaking. For To Tell the Truth, this program was recorded.